Hey, it's me again. I was finishing this cigarette just to make a point. The point that's just not, people just aren't getting. Well, I'm not going to say people aren't getting it. I mean, the last video was pretty well received, got pretty good ratings. So somebody must get it, but obviously the commenters don't get it. Alright, so I smoke cigarettes. Now, everything, you know, every intellectual thought, neuron, my brain says this is stupid, okay? It's a waste, it's nonsense, it's garbage, it's rubbish, it's shit. And it's only because the chemical nicotine has this addictive property. And so my psychology is owned by that addiction. And so my psychology, my brain, yells for this thing, screams for it. Like a baby, like a non-thinking entity, a wanting thing. It wants it, okay? It turns a want into a need as a practical fact. It's powerful want, okay? That's documented fact. Millions of people intellectually, philosophically, scientifically, objectively know it's a garbage habit. A garbage addiction. They know it's an addiction. They use that word. All right. And so you're just not getting it. You know, you can't combine psychology and philosophy. They're two different things. I mean, you can. I mean, there's no law against it. Nobody's going to arrest you. But I'm just saying it's intellectually nonsense. You know, unless we come up with a different word for philosophy. If philosophy isn't about the truth, if it's just finding your scheme to get through life, and you call that philosophy, well, then we need a different word. Because in my brain, the word philosophy is associated with an effort to define reality, not an effort to scheme your way through life, your individual life. So if philosophy is just personal rubbish, in your opinion, in your definition, well then yeah, we need a different word. For when people are pursuing the truth, an accurate description of reality. All right, so there's, you know, so many things that are obviously being misunderstood. So let's just get to the important point for you people to understand is I'm not just saying this to ridicule the stupidity of your life or the addictions you're caught up in, because we're all caught up in addictions. We're all caught up in a psychology. My point is not to eliminate you or eliminate your desire. My point is that maybe before we inject new victims into the game, we should probably define what a psychology should look like and maybe try to engineer it to turn out that way. So you don't create people who at 7 years old realize they're in a loony bin. It's a madhouse. I remember seeing Planet of the Apes when I was a kid. And, you know, when he was screaming, it's a madhouse, that was just so perfect to me. That's exactly what I was feeling. You know, here we were talking about some alien civilization, and I was feeling it about this human civilization. This is a madhouse. Humans are crazy, motherfucking crazy. They're possessed by fucking addictions, desire, want. That doesn't come from their intelligence. It comes from their chemistry, their biology, and ultimately their motherfucking DNA. I mean, you're owned by a damn molecule. I've said it before, I'm gonna say it again and again and again until somebody makes a rational argument demonstrating how that DNA isn't controlling your goddamn psychology, because it is. So anyway, it's got a point that's got to be stressed here is it's not about you giving up on your personal life. It's about humanity giving up on the notion that it can just do this sloppy, that it can just keep fucking popping out these goddamn human beings into this chaos and feel justified in doing that. There's no fucking justification for it. I mean, until you know what the fuck you're doing, you have no business being in the creation business. It's a highly skilled, very dangerous business to be in. It's like having, nuclear wheelchairs or something. I mean, you wouldn't just let that be an unregulated industry, the nuclear wheelchair industry. No, you'd say you got to regulate those fuckers. You got to control that shit because it's very dangerous. And this creation thing is dangerous. There's all kinds of liability out there. All right. And so in the video, I attempted to illustrate to you that there's a whole lot of life out there, humans, living lives that would embarrass you if you had to live it. You'd be embarrassed to be that stupid, or you'd be embarrassed to be that desirous, or gluttonous, or whatever the term is. And there's even lives where you'd say, holy shit, I'd be horrified if I had to live through that experience. Apparently some of you just don't get that. You just, you're so caught up in your own life and your own prospect that nothing, that you're immune to everything, that you just don't get it. You can't even use your imagination to think what it might be like to die of AIDS when you're 7 years old and how horrible, horrible that experience might be. But that's what we're, if you can't understand the simple concept that you have a consciousness, but you don't possess the idea of consciousness. You only have one tiny little piece of it, and it goes on, and it lives on. And all those other consciousnesses are just as real as your consciousness. So how can you not get that essentially if you sentence consciousness to exist in that state, you're sentencing yourself to exist in that state. There's no real difference. I mean, it's just as real as you. Can't you get this shit? I mean, how can this be too complicated for you? And that's where you make this difference between philosophy and psychology. Because our psychology is obsessed with our inner being, our personal life, our personal experience. But consciousness is not doing your personal experience. It's doing that 7 billion other people experience. That's the fucking reality. And the equation is just so simple. You can't win if consciousness exists in shit. Then you exist in shit. Even if you don't personally exist in it, if consciousness is existing in it, you might as well be existing in it. I don't know why this is. Again, I'll use this analogy that I think it's a pretty good analogy. Let's say you had two kids, or three kids, and the life equation statistically meant that one of those kids dies at 16, one of them, divorces and, blah, blah, whatever the scenario is. I mean, you gotta understand, that's the real world, okay? You can't statistically, just because you think you're gonna have the power to avoid that reality, if those statistics are there, that's there's no point in even saying it, because yeah, most people think they're immune. Real life isn't gonna touch them. They ignore the risk and just presume they're gonna win the lottery. They're gonna hit all the right numbers. None of the negative lotteries tickets that they're all entered in just by living. They're not going to be the winner of the shit lottery. There's no explaining this. But I mean, you're basically, when we create consciousness, we're the parent of consciousness. And if we know that, rich people are living off of poor people, if we know they're eating them essentially, then it's like having one of your kids eating another one of your kids. How the fuck do you win in that scenario? You can't. And that's the nature of this game we're playing. It can't be won, I say. But even if I'm wrong about that, and there's some slim chance that you can work this thing out and make it better and perfect and all that kind of crap, we're not doing that. So until we start doing that, you have no business playing the game. I mean, Pyro talks like, well, if you don't like it, just bail out. Well, we don't even have that choice, Pyro. So until, I guess, that choice exists, you got nothing to say. You got no justification, because that choice doesn't exist. So maybe you ought to fix that before you advocate that anybody have any more kids, including your fucking self. But you don't do that. You just say, well, it should be. Well, it should be is not a good enough excuse for you making things happen, okay, before the circumstance that you use to justify them happening exists. Create the circumstance first, then use it as a justification. So I gotta cross the stream, so we'll call it an end here. Thank you very much. I don't know what I'll have to say on the way home, but we'll see. All right, response video.